Santa Claus is coming to town at an average of 650 miles per second. It's not quite as catchy, but then again, mathematics never really made for a great holiday album. First, let's get a few assumptions out of the way. Santa exists, reindeers can fly, and both of them can travel at about any speed without bursting into flame. All right, how fast would Santa Claus have to travel to deliver presents to all the good little boys and girls on his list? It turns out this little exercise has been used by physics teachers around the world for years, and the most used example is an article published in 1991 in Spy magazine. Let's go through that example. First, it establishes the parameters. According to population data taken at the time this article was written, there were 2 billion children under the age of 18, but Santa would not have to deliver to all of them, only to the ones that explicitly celebrate Christmas, or about 375 million kids. Our example assumes that 15% of these children do not get anything. They are on the naughty list, and there are 3.5 children per household. That's pretty high, but it still leaves 92 million homes for Santa to visit in just one night. Finally, thanks to the rotation of the Earth, Santa has 31 hours to deliver all of his presents. So how fast would Santa have to actually go to make all these stops? If all these trips are evenly spaced out against the Earth's surface, that's still 823 trips per second for Santa over a 73 million mile trip. Now, over this time frame and that distance, Santa's average speed would have to be a blistering 650 miles per second. That is fast. In fact, that's fast enough to escape the gravity of our galaxy. Santa might be festively plump, but all those presents is where the weight is. If each child gets maybe 2 pounds of gifts on average, then that's 64 million pounds of gifts, or about the weight of a supertanker. When what is effectively a supersonic supertanker is rocketing around the atmosphere, air resistance becomes a problem. Air can't move out of the way fast enough when you're going 650 miles per second, so the leading pack of Santa's reindeer would be turned into a pack of plasma. Just the acceleration and deceleration alone to get up to that speed during each trip would turn any man less jolly into a tub full of jelly. But like all magic men, Santa Claus is not confined by our rudimentary understanding of physics. He must be more heat resistant than a space shuttle is using a propulsion system centuries ahead of our own, and must have some kind of cloaking device that would make even a Klingon jelly. Of course, there are other explanations for how all these presents are getting to all these kids, but plasmified reindeer are way cooler anyway. Why? Because science da-da-da-da-ba-da-ba, because science da-dow! Want more science? Check out my last video on how dragons might actually breathe fire. Click to subscribe for more videos, and if you have any comments or questions, make sure to hit me up in the comment section below. Thanks!